This video is to allow you to correct your homework for section 6.2.5, problems 6.115 through 6.119. So the first thing they want you to do is to sketch the shape on your paper, write an expression for the perimeter of the shape, then find the perimeter for each of the given values of x. Now, in terms of sketching this, you could put it in your notebook and then take a picture of it, or you could use your e-tool and screenshot it. But in terms of perimeter, what we would have is this length is x, so is this, so is this, so is this, and then these lengths are all 1. Whoops, I want a different color there. So this is 1, 1, 1, and 1. So the perimeter then would be 4x plus 4, and of course the label is units. Then what we're doing is we're replacing x right here with the x value they give us. So we're going to have three different answers. So I should see that you replaced x with 7. So I should see that you took 4 times 7 plus 4. Again, I've got just the answer, but you need to show some work. So you'd have 4 times 7 plus 4 would be 28 plus 4, or 32 units. Again, we know a number in front of a letter means multiply, so we're multiplying the 4 times that 7. Then I should see that you took 4 times 5.5 and then added 4. Again, you could do as a calculator, but show me what you put into the calculator. And you get 26 units. And then 4 times 7/3 plus 4. And you end up getting 13 1/3. Now, you might have also gotten 13.3 repeating as a decimal. Here, you just had to put the numbers in order from least to greatest. And, of course, the negative numbers are going to be smaller than the positive. So negative 3/4 is smaller than negative 1/4. And then 3/5 is bigger than the negative numbers between 0 and 1. 1 2/5 is bigger than that. And 7/3 is the same as 2 1/3, so that's the largest. Here you had to take this picture, copy it, and then enlarge or reduce it by these ratios. So you're going to take this original sketch and enlarge it by a ratio of 3:1. So what you should have is a new sketch where instead of the lengths being what they were, which this length was 3, for example, once I multiply it by a ratio of 3:1, now that length is 9. Okay, same thing here, here, and here. They were all 3, so they all now have a length of 9. And then these were originally lengths of 6, and so 6 multiplied by a ratio of 3:1 would mean that the new lengths would be 18. So again, you should have a picture of that as well as the numbers included. For this one, you're going to multiply those same lengths by 2/3. Well, if you take 3 times 2/3, you're going to get a length of 2. So it now will be 2, 2, 2, and 2. And then 6 multiplied by 2/3 would be lengths of 4. And again, I should see some work. Like, okay, I took 3 times 2/3. I know the way to do that is to make it 3/1 times 2/3. I can simplify my 3s before I multiply, simplify before I multiply. And that's how I'm getting those lengths of 2, or 6 times 2/3, giving you the length of 4. Molly's raising cows. She has a pasture for them that is 6,500 square miles in area. One dimension is 4/10 miles long. What's the length of the other? So we basically know that if we have a rectangle, and we know the area of that rectangle, which in this case is 6,500 square miles, and we know one of the dimensions of the rectangle, 4/10, then the way to find the other dimension will be to divide, because to find the area of a rectangle, you take length times width, and you get this area. So if you want to go the opposite to get the missing value, you're going to take the area and divide by this. Okay, so I should see that you took 6,500 and divided by 4/10. Which will give you a length of 1 625,000 miles. So this is the number one, but this is the answer. And then how much fencing will you need to go around the pasture? Well, if this is 1,625,000, you're going to add that twice plus the 4/10 twice. And again, I should see what you put into the calculator, and you're going to get an answer of 4.5 miles. But again, make sure you write down what you put into the calculator. Here you're going to find the approximate location of these on a number line, and this is considered part of a checkpoint because it's skills they are checking to make sure you know. So first of all, you're going to say the approximate locations of these spots on the numbers, and then for part B, tell the name of each point on the coordinate plane. So you can see what they have here, okay, and then you can see what we have here. So on the number line, and then the ordered pairs.